Well, hello everyone, Tex88 here, and welcome to another retro gaming review. And this time I bring you the coin-op conversion of Gemini Wing for the Sinclair ZX Spectrum. This came out in 1989, and Imagitech Design were responsible for the actual conversion itself, so it's a vertically scrolling shoot-em-up, so let's get this show on the road. So I'm that ship that's at the bottom middle of the screen right now. Oh dear, I'm running out of lives. Oh dear me. Some nice use of colour I've noticed, and the backgrounds are incredibly detailed. Little bit of attribute clash at times, especially when... Oh, poo sticks. Oh no. Okay, let's try that again. Oh, I've blown that. Never mind. Okay, let's see if we can get a bit further this time. Crikey. I'm actually starting to wish that the backgrounds weren't quite as detailed as this, because I know that these graphics look really impressive when you look at them on paper, especially when you get to this canyon section here, but vertically scrolling shoot 'em ups on the Spectrum are always quite a challenge because of the monochrome graphics that are often used to get around its attribute problem. I'm really finding it quite hard to see what's actually happening on screen because these busy backgrounds are really interfering with the sprites. I mean, I can only just make out some of the enemies because it's so detailed, it's nigh on impossible to see it much. Scrolling's pretty easy. Oh, crikey, I can barely see those. You see, look at that background. It looks really impressive, if you allow for the fact that it's in monochrome, but it's just so hard to see what's happening. Oh, God. I've just lost a life there. Scrolling quite nice. They managed to find some ways to get some colour into the proceedings without too much in the way of attribute clash. Oh crap! I can barely see what's happening because these backgrounds are so detailed. Ooh, I've got a nice meaty weapon here. Oh dear, there's quite a bit of colour clash for that weapon, unfortunately. It's a shame there's no in-game music. As far as I know, I don't know whether I'm actually playing the 48K version, in which case it wouldn't be surprising that there's not that much music. I've never played this particular version before, so I don't know if the 128K version has music on it. Oh God, I can barely see these. I mean, I'm sorry that I keep banging on about it, but this is a continuous problem. Oh, God. I'm really struggling to see what's going on at times. That water effect's just so visually busy. We're back to these cloud-like things again. It might be a little bit easier to... Oh, spoke too soon, didn't I? Sound effects are a bit sparse, but remember this is a spec. Oh crap. Ooh. One more go. I would like to get a bit further than I did just then, but the problem is it's so hard when it's hard to see anything. When it's this background, it's not too bad. It's just when you get into the canyon in a moment that it starts to get a little bit troublesome. Anyone who remembers when I reviewed Light Force not so long ago, that made great use of colour, and there was never a problem with not being able to see what was happening on screen. Although the colour did mean it had to have character by character movement and give away black outlines, so you wouldn't. That's why that game didn't really have the smooth scrolling that you have quite the same level of smooth scrolling that you see in this. Oh crap. Oh god, I can barely see these. I'm too afraid to let my off the fire button because it's so hard to see anything. I've just lost another life. Oh. Oh, Conan. What are these things anyway? Oh, I've destroyed that. It's so hard to destroy some of those tube things on the side. I mean, what are they? I can barely see what's happening. It's such a shame. Because there's actually a promising shoot 'em up in here. I mean, the controls are responsive enough and the... Oh, I see. That weapon meter on the right stops advancing upwards if I stop fire, holding down fire. But trouble is, I'm afraid to not hold down fire because it's so hard to see enemies for most of this because of the really complicated monochrome backgrounds. One more life left. No. So there you have it, Gemini Wing for the Sinclair ZX Spectrum. I mean, there's potential in there for a pretty entertaining little vertically scrolling shoot 'em up, but it's let down by the Spectrum's manifold limitations when it comes to having colour with minimal or no colour clash. And That's where it falters. So graphics, when you see them in stills, they look pretty nice and they're quite impressive and detailed. But as you'll find out when I get to gameplay, that is also it's the game's main downfall. Sound is... it's a bit sparse given that this game came out in 1989 and Light Force came out a few years earlier and had quite a really good use of sound effects. And I am starting to think that this is actually I'm starting to wonder whether this is actually a 48K version. If someone can confirm to me one way or the other in the comments, I did try and get a disc version to work in case it was a 128K version, but I couldn't get that to work, so this is the only version I could get to work. So anyway, sound is a bit disappointing considering what had come before it in that time. Gameplay. While the controls are smooth and responsive enough, unfortunately the whole experience is spoiled by the fact that the really detailed backgrounds mean that it's really hard to see what's happening on screen. I was really struggling to see a lot of those enemies at the best of times, especially in that canyon section and whenever... and that bit above the water when the background was really busy. And I just think it's a real shame because what I could make out of it, it made up for a fairly interesting vertically scrolling shoot-em-up that could have been quite fun, but the fact that you can barely see what's happening on screen because of the overly detailed backgrounds kind of ruins it. So I'm going to give Gemini Wing on the Spectrum 4 out of 10. There's a potentially good game in there, but the fact you can't really see what's going on it blights the whole experience. So, hope you all enjoyed this review. Texi88 out.